Good morning. We are in a little bit of an unusual spot this morning because we're at Darnell Farms. Now, let me tell you the backstory on that. A while back, the kindergarten, first grade, and second grade asked if they could make their annual trip to the pumpkin patch in the middle of our COVID concerns. And I said, you know, I think that we can because these kids are together quite a bit during school. We just need to make sure that we have masks on them, that we use the mitigation features that we normally use in other places. So that's where we are this morning. As I went out to West yesterday to check on a couple of things, one of the teacher assistants said, you know what you need to do in the morning, Mark? You need to come to Darnell Farms to the pumpkin patch with us. And I said, you know what? I'm going to do that. So we're here and we're just going to give you some video of them having a good time, and we'll probably maybe even have a conversation with the teacher or two. Now before we get to that though, I've got some shout outs today. Our middle school volleyball team, who, if I'm not mistaken, won the conference championship this year, and they had zero defeats. They were undefeated for the season. Congratulations to all of our middle school coaches and our team members for the excellent season, and also to the other athletes who are competing. If you've been following football, our football team has been doing very well playing against some of our conference competition. Now, we've got a big game on this Friday against Murphy, and it's at Swain. Could I please encourage you to come and to cheer them on? And then next Tuesday, there's a Robbinsville game that we've had to reschedule. That will be in Robbinsville. And then the following Friday, on October the 28th, we'll be playing Cherokee at home for our final conference game for varsity football. I would encourage you to please be part of any of those. Also, just across the hill from where we are, and remember, we're at Darnell Farms, there's going to be a cross-country meet on Wednesday. That's tomorrow, and I would encourage you to come and to encourage those students as well, because if I'm not mistaken, our cross-country teams are something to watch right now. I think that's really all that we need to share, except report cards are coming out this coming Friday, and I believe that that's the 25th or the 26th, so make sure that you're looking for those. You know, you've heard enough from me. I just want for you to be able to enjoy some of the things that our kindergarten students are doing, so I'm going to turn you loose and turn Joe loose and just get some video for that, and maybe at the end we'll come back with a teacher interview or something like that. All right, so just stay tuned and watch for a little bit.
Okay, we're gonna get on the tractors in a minute. You guys excited about going on a hayride?
Yeah!
Are you excited about going on a hayride?
Yeah!
Oh my gosh, I love it. This is the best. This is always my favorite class of the kindergartens from Swain County. You guys are awesome. How about your teachers? Do you love your teachers?
Yeah!
Do you love your teachers?
Yeah!
You got good teachers. I know you do.
I want you to know how excited I am. That's why I'm up on this tractor standing here yelling. So are you ready to go for a hayride?
Yeah!
I'm going to ask you one more time. Are you ready to go?
Yeah!
All right.
I'm standing here with Hannah Farmer, and I think that is the word is apropos, because we're speaking with Miss Farmer at the farm.
Yes.
I know that was cheap. I'm sorry, but whatever. So Miss Farmer is a kindergarten teacher, and I want to ask you just a couple of questions. All right, have you had a good time today?
I've had a wonderful time today.
So do you think your students are enjoying this?
Oh yeah, you can tell. They are just so excited. They can hardly contain themselves.
I believe that that's true, listening to them on the hayride, and then as we walked through the corn maze a few minutes ago, that was kind of neat. So Hannah, why are we doing this? I mean, what are the students getting out of this, perhaps that they couldn't get somewhere else?
Well, they get hands-on experience. They get to see it firsthand. Pictures and things that toys and stuff just doesn't express, and where, you know, like hands-on things can. Like, they actually can see the roots. They can actually handle a pumpkin. They can actually see a farm and how it works and what the workers do. We can talk about it all day long, but unless they experience that, it's not going to be ingrained in them and what that means to them. They'll remember this for the rest of their life.
I would agree with you on that, and that's one of the reasons that we do it multiple times also, because I know that kindergarten is coming, or is here today. Second grade was here, I believe, yesterday, and first and third grade are scheduled to come later, because again, every time that they come, they see something different from a different perspective. Yes. I think that's great.
So it starts at a foundation and they just keep building and they learn new things every year.
Well, I think it's time for lunch.
Yes.
So you better find your class and finish out your day. Thank you for spending time with us. And thank you all for spending time with us as well. This has been a great day for me. It's been a great day for these kids. And I am so thankful that we're able to get out and to do some of these things. So until the next time, God bless you. You have a great day. And thank you for letting us be part of your family.